It may be hard to believe, but people just like you are already saving money. FeedThePig.org makes it easy. Their simple savings plan teaches you how to start saving without going overboard. So you don't need to ditch the car and start rollerblading to work.
I look ridiculous.
You look ridiculous!
You don't need to start foraging wild berries.
I was skeptical, but these are actually pretty good.
You don't need to sell your organs on the black market.
Lie back. This is gonna hurt.
Yeah, that hurts.
You don't need to rent out your apartment to drifters.
I made a fire with the wood in your bedroom.
That's my dresser!
And your closet door.
You just need an internet connection. Don't get left behind. Start your personal savings plan with the tips and tools on feedthepig.org. That way, you don't need to sell all your belongings and live in a commune.
These dungarees belong to all of us now, Tom.
Brought to you by the American Institute of CPAs and the Ad Council.
Resistance is futile.
And now, a show that boldly goes where no show has gone before. The Week in Geek, with your hosts, David DeCorbier and Brian Held. Here to cover the hottest trends and topics in science fiction news and events, with movie, book, and game reviews, cosplay, comic book, and convention commentary, interviews with authors, media guests, and local fandom. So raise your nerd flag high and prepare to be assimilated. This is the Week in Geek. And now, here's your hosts, David DeCorbier and Brian Held.
Good afternoon, New Orleans. This is the Week in Geek. I'm your host, David DeCorbier, with
Brian Held.
And I don't know why our Facebook moderator, Brandon Black, can't figure out how to use the damn TuneIn radio app. He's not getting it, so I don't know. He's working on my phone. I double-checked it. The feed is live. We are live, so...
And maybe he needs to break out his transistor radio.
Put some tinfoil on that there antenna.
Yep.
So, all right, guys, this is The Week in Geek, and as always, we strongly urge you to check out the Facebook page, facebook.com/TheWeekInGeek. Follow us on Twitter at Twig Radio, and check out the website, twigradio.com. Brian, how can they listen to this wonderful show? And they will want to listen to this show in perpetuity because of the Megabots, guys.
Yeah, yeah. So, there's a couple of ways. First, you can go to WGSO.com. Click in the top left under podcast and just scroll on down till you find Week in Geek. All of our archives are there. But like we just mentioned, you can listen to us live on that website. Also, if you don't have your computer around, you can download the TuneIn Radio app for your smartphone or tablet. Just go there. You can listen to us live, and the archives are there as well.
So, Brian, tell us a little bit about our guest that's coming on in the next segment.
So, yeah, we've got, I contacted the guys from, Megabots Incorporated, and that's going to be the giant robot duel between, USA and Japan. So a lot of excitement. I don't want to get too much into it, but, those guys are going to be coming on shortly, and, I'm pretty excited.
All right. And so also, you know, we'll do a little bit of This Week in Geek History, Top Nerd News. And also, we're going to bring back Brian Hill, Super Groovy, Hit of the Week.
I'm scared.
Waka waka. You should be. Be afraid. Be very afraid. So I guess without much further ado, let's bring on our boy Scungy and his Pick of the Week.
Scungy's Pick of the Week.
I am not what you would call a handsome man.
Scungy's Pick of the Week is brought to you by Wits Inn Bar and Pizza Kitchen. Find them on the web at witsinn.com. Scungy's Pick of the Week.
I love lamp. I love lamp.
Scungy, what's shaking bacon?
Bonjour, bonjour, comment ça va?
What are you, French? Get over here, you dirty frog. What's your pick today, Monsieur Scungy?
My pick today is a little game called Until Dawn.
Okay.
Okay. What's that?
It's an exclusive to the PlayStation 4, so I know that already makes you angry, Dave.
Just talk. I don't care what you're saying anymore. Talk to Brian.
Okay, so, well, hold on real quick, Scungy, just to interrupt you. One of our listeners actually wanted to ask you, isn't the PS4 the best-selling... peasant box, I'm sorry, console that's out there on the market?
It is the best-selling console, not peasant box. All right, sir, you Mr. High and Mighty, with your nose up in the air so high that airplanes could fly into it.
All right.
So it is the best-selling console. Just tell us about your stupid piece for your PS4 game.
Yes.
What is it? Talk, damn you!
Until Dawn. Okay. Until Dawn is a game about 8 friends who go to a log cabin in the woods and they're being stalked by a serial killer.
Oh, okay. I'm liking it now.
Okay. So it's got that slasher flick kind of feel to it. Now, each playthrough is going to be about 10 hours. Now, I say each playthrough because this game has multiple paths and multiple endings to it. It has a mechanic called a butterfly effect, where you make one decision, a small decision early in the game, and then later on that comes back to and it'll play into the storyline. Now, you have ethical and moral choices in this game, such as you got to pick somebody, because of a choice you made earlier in the game, now it comes around where you have a choice between one person dying or another person dying, and you have to choose.
So I got to ask real quick, because some of the early, rough graphics or even text-based type games years ago.
Zork?
Zork, for instance. If you made some sort of decision early on, you could, box yourself in. This is not going to happen, is it?
No, you're not gonna box yourself in. And that's the cool thing about it. They made it where any choice you make, you're going to be able to finish the game. But it's also, they're trying to make it a very cinematic feel. That's why the game has an autosave feature. So once you make a choice, you can't go back on that choice.
Okay. Oh, interesting. All right.
So it's like a living thing. Now, they say there is a way for everybody to survive. It's really unlikely, though.
So who's your main antagonist, or would that be a spoiler?
Well, they haven't really gone into it because they try to keep it, they're trying to keep it like under wraps because it is a horror story, so you want to be surprised and whatnot.
Okay.
The main protagonist you're playing, though, is Hayden Panettiere, who played Claire, the cheerleader from Heroes.
All right, yeah. All right. Save the cheerleader, save the world.
But you get to play as many different people in this game. But the main antagonist is a serial killer. You're in this cabin that you're there for the 1-year anniversary of the disappearance of these twins. That's all they're really letting you know. They're not giving a lot of details to it.
That's just silly. Who would go out to a cabin in the woods to celebrate the disappearance of 2 little kids? Yay! Let's go smoke a bong and miss these kids and hope we don't die.
Maybe we could disappear too.
Right.
I mean, it's the formula for a slasher flick. I mean, it doesn't matter if you're supposed to do it or not. It's in the script.
Oh, you're right. So, so y'all recommending this game?
Yeah, I am, because it's a new, it's kind of a trend that's starting to happen, and where you have a very cinematic experience. It's very reminiscent of games like Heavy Rain or Beyond Two Souls, which had a very less of a gameplay feel, more of a I'm playing a movie type feel.
So I'm compelled to ask, is there going to be release day DLC?
They haven't really discussed yet, but I think they said that there may be some coming. They haven't said, yes, we're going to have DLC, but they haven't said that it's out of the realm of possibility.
All right. No, that's cool. That's kind of aggravating when you get that release day stuff and it's like, really, you couldn't incorporate that in? Like, I feel like I'm getting cheated, you know?
Yeah. Yeah, exactly. That is one trend that a lot of people are starting more and more to not like, especially when the content's on the disc itself.
Yeah.
All right, Scungy. So this next week, Tuesday, Madden comes out. The new Madden. Are you going to be super excited for that? Are you going to be up really late for a midnight review or whatever the hell they call it?
Oh, it's going to be crazy. It's especially in this city, not so much in the rest of the country. Madden's not nearly as big in the rest of the country as it is in this state.
That's weird.
We're like the top state for Madden sales.
Nice. Way to go.
So it's really big around here. Other places
yay,
like
sports
oh,
ball.
Madden. Ooh. Here we're like football.
Yeah, right. Your Saints play today. 6:37,
yes,
something. I don't know. We play that. The hated Patriots.
Ooh.
Brian doesn't even know who the hell the Patriots are either.
They're,
Tom Brady, he dates a supermodel.
They're one of those
sports ball
teams.
His balls. He plays with his balls on the field. That guy. All right, Scudgy. Well, look, we'll talk to you next week, and I don't know what the hell we're doing. So.
You won't talk to me. I'll be in
next
Las
week.
Vegas, Nevada.
Oh.
Right. So we're going to have Brandon Black in place of Scungy to talk about the upcoming.
Cairo by Gaslight?
Cairo by Gaslight.
Bada bing, bada boom.
And
hey.
Our guest will be Ted Wally.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah,
right,
local
right.
comic artist. Yeah.
Nice. All right, guys. Well, you're listening to The Week in Geek. I'm your host, David Corbier, with
Brian Held.
And when we get back from these short commercial messages, we will. Ideally, be talking to the Megabots guys.
Yes.
If not, we have other great stuff planned for you. But the Megabots guys are coming up.
Yep.
So stay tuned. This is WGSO 990 AM.
Spirits on Bourbon. Spirits on Bourbon. Come to 615 Bourbon, home of the resurrection. Try their gumbo, wings, couchon de lait, or a ribeye steak. Have a shot on Edward's barber chair or sit at his haunted table. Check out their website at spiritsonbourbon.com and watch their video from Spike TV's Bar Rescue. Come to Spirits on Bourbon for a haunting good time.
Wits Inn Bar and Pizza Kitchen. Wits Inn is an upscale neighborhood bar and pizza kitchen in the heart of Mid-City at 141 North Carrollton. Wits Inn is open 7 days a week and the kitchen is always open late. Make Wits Inn your home for sports. With 18 TVs, the NFL package, and the SCC channel, you'll never miss a game. Check out our food and drink specials like Thursday $5 pizzas and the Wit Maker at WITSINN.com. Wits Inn Bar and Pizza Kitchen. Think, drink, live, laugh.
Come to New Orleans' friendly local gaming shop, Gopher Games, located on 701 David Drive in Metairie. Games like Warhammer, War Machine, Magic the Gathering, HeroClix, Pathfinder, and many more. Visit us at gophergamesnola.com. That's G-O, the number 4, gamesnola.com, for the latest news and upcoming events. We're open 7 days a week. Call us at 504-324-8335 or come on by. Gopher Games, a hangout for gamers by gamers.
Leave the smoke behind and come chase the clouds at the Vaping Tiger in Metairie. The Vaping Tiger has everything to suit your vaping needs, from starter kits to advanced devices. We specialize in handcrafted, artisan-blended e-juices designed to tickle the most fickle taste buds. Come see us at 2812 Athenia Parkway, one block off Vets behind the Lazy Boy Gallery. That's the Vaping Tiger, 2812 Athenia Parkway, and at VapingTiger.com. Come out of the smoke and join us in the clouds.
In a New Orleans that never was and never will be, airships float high above the city while platoons of clockwork automatons patrol the streets below. In Storyville, pirates, streetwalkers, gamblers, and thieves prowl back alleys in search of their next mark. New Orleans by Gaslight, the premier anthology of locally written and locally produced steampunk poetry and fiction, all set in Victorian New Orleans. Buy it now, available in both paperback and Kindle versions at Amazon.com. New Orleans by Gaslight. Tubby and Coos Mid-City Bookshop. Before you get booked up, head over to 631 North Carrollton right off Orleans to Tubby and Coos Mid-City Bookshop. Off the books, Tubby and Coos is a nerd mecca for books, board games, and geeky t-shirts. So book it over to Tubby and Coos Mid-City Bookshop at 631 North Carrollton. If you don't want to do it by the book, use their free Wi-Fi and check their stock at tubbyandcoos.com. Tubby and Coos Mid-City Bookshop, where it's all geek to me.
I am Lufa Rigno. You are listening to The Week in Geek, WGSO 99 AM, and keep listening because you won't like me when I get angry.
Today we face the monsters that are at our door and bring the fight to them. Today we are canceling the apocalypse.
This is The Week in Geek. I'm your host, David DeCorbier, with
Brian Held.
And we are canceling the apocalypse because we have on the phone
Matt Orlon.
Yes, you got, yes. You got his last name correct.
Yeah.
I butchered it earlier. So this is... I'm too excited. I want to cancel the apocalypse.
So, yeah, so this is Matt Orlon with Megamont Incorporated. How are you, sir?
I'm great.
Awesome.
Thanks for taking the call.
Most definitely. No, we're excited to have you, man. So, you know, for those few folks out there that may not know what's going on, tell us about this giant robot duel.
So, Megabots is the most patriotic robotics company in the world. We have built a 15-foot-tall, 12,000-pound giant piloted robot that two people sit inside and drive around and blow things up in. And we recently challenged the only other giant piloted robot in the world that we know of, which is in Japan. The robot's called the Karatas robot. We challenged them to a duel about a month and a half ago, and they said yes. And so now the duel is on. We're going to have a giant international robot duel fight in about a year. But they said they wanted melee combat. They wanted the robots to punch each other.
Yeah, I know. You've got guns on your guy, and they want melee.
Yeah. So we, as Americans, of course, built a big, giant thing, and we stuck.
Uh-oh. Did we lose him?
I think we might have lost him.
Wait, I think what he was about to say was they stuck guns on it.
Oh, of course, yeah.
Because an American robot must have guns. We lost him?
Yeah.
Okay, all right, well... Hey, we got him back.
All right,
let's put him back on. But yeah, it's those the air cannons that were shooting potatoes into a car.
Yeah, and
watch the video.
Yeah,
so, and paintballs. Matt? Okay, Matt, you're back, huh?
Yeah.
All right, so we left off where it's an American robot and you put guns on it.
Right, so it's an American robot. We put huge guns on it. The Japanese team wants melee combat, hand-to-hand combat, so we've taken the Kickstarter to upgrade our robot to put a giant chainsaw on it and all kinds of really crazy over the top, like a flame throwing cigar and like giant eagle mouths that shoot a chain gun out of them and just make this big ridiculous robot.
The mock-ups look great. So actually, let's talk about that Kickstarter because I'm so blown away by some of the information that you provide on the Kickstarter, all the folks who are supporting this endeavor, like the big names. So tell us, where do we find the Kickstarter? Where are we at? What do we need to get to?
Sure. So probably the easiest way to get to the Kickstarter is actually just go to megabots.com, and then there's just a big button right at the top that just says, go to our Kickstarter page.
Yeah, big green button.
You know, big green button, just megabots.com, big green button. And that'll get you there. Otherwise, I mean, you can type in Google. If you type in, like, Kickstarter giant robot, like, you're probably going to get there, too. We're all over the internet right now.
Oh, yeah.
But, yeah. So big names. We have Grant Imahara, a former MythBuster, who's on our board of advisors. We've got NASA. We have the top American team in the DARPA Robotics Challenge. This was that kind of crazy walking humanoid robot challenge that maybe some of you guys saw that happened a few months ago. Who else do we have? These like really advanced tank tread manufacturers.
Oh man, those little speed tanks, those things are phenomenal. Yeah, I noticed y'all need more weight and balance on that bad boy, so you need bigger treads, so that's a good guy to get. Don't y'all have
we want to speed this thing up so it can throw some pretty sweet punches. So these guys make tank treads that go like 70 something miles an hour.
Nice.
They use like a 700 horsepower diesel engine to like make these ridiculously fast.
They look like Hiss tanks from Cobra.
Oh yeah, yeah.
that's why I immediately thought of them. So, and y'all have the BattleBots guy too, right? The BattleBots.
Yeah. So the co-creators of BattleBots are helping us out, kind of navigate the entertainment world of giant fighting of fighting robots, really. And so they've been great. They're kind of taking on an advisory role. They're out here in the Bay Area too. So, they've been great.
Have y'all ever thought of getting like a paid spokesperson since your robot's going to have a giant chainsaw? Any thought about maybe getting Bruce Campbell to do that, you know, of Evil Dead fame?
I'm sure we're going to have some kind of announcer, spokesman, but we're thinking about like trying to get like Arnold Schwarzenegger or something to be like maybe one of our pilots or something like that. You know,
get down, the robot is coming. The robot is coming, yeah. Get down the chopper.
Exactly.
Yeah.
So lots of opportunity to do kind of wacky stuff with celebrities and whatnot. But yeah, super, super fun project. Everyone likes it. Brings out the patriotism in everyone. It's been great so far.
So you have all of these goals on the Kickstarter page, the, you know, what happens past, 500K, 600, 700. And are those like, do we have to get there in order to get, you know, those folks to come in and start participating?
Yeah, we do essentially.
Okay.
So at 500,000, we get the tank tread guys. And then at, I think, 750,000, we build a whole suite of weapons. So we'll build all kinds of crazy, like, you know, the chainsaw thing, concrete saws, big fists that, you know, pneumatically punch, like giant jackhammer thing, you know, all kinds of stuff. And we'll test it all and see what works the best. I think at a million, we get a dynamic balanced algorithm. So these are like the super high-end robotics guys that are going to help us make the robot balance so that when we take a punch, the thing can kind of like stagger back and catch its balance, you know, and change this thing into like the world's biggest Segway, essentially.
Well, and you know, look, it's obvious that we need robot jocks, right? That we, you know, we need to have this battle. So, you know, folks are not just throwing money at you, right? I mean, there's prizes or you know, somebody's going to get stuff back for giving their money. What kind of things do they have on the Kickstarter?
Sure. So down kind of at the, you know, starting levels for backing, there's things like stickers and T-shirts and 3D printed toys of the Mark II, which is what we call a robot. And then at the higher end, you can go all the way up to things like getting inside the robot and swing punches at a Toyota Prius hanging from a construction crane. You can just use this Japanese car as a punching bag on
nice.
a demo day.
Because America!
And I think, exactly. And I think there are, I'm not sure if there's any slots left, but we do have some slots for pit crew to basically join us, work on the robot, and then, you know, like, be behind the scenes during the fight.
So I went and I did a little investigation of our distinguished competition over in Japan, and I noticed that they have a Windows control system in their robot. Are you hoping for a blue screen of death for the fight?
Yeah, you know, I figure I can just like connect a keyboard to them and maybe just hit Control Alt Delete. maybe with some success that could, you know,
just lock them out.
Take them down.
So where is this battle? Have y'all picked an arena?
We haven't picked an arena yet. We've had a ton of offers. I think both teams, we kind of like the idea of having it in neutral ground. And we've had offers from all over the world. But it's kind of a balance between picking a place that is sort of neutral, but like also lets us bring in giant, you know, war machines, I guess. So the import-export, you know, controls have to be a little bit lax. Bringing these types of things to Russia, we've heard, is very difficult from other, you know, giant robot makers.
Yeah.
And so, you know, we have to think about, like, what's easy to get through customs-wise.
Right.
And so that's kind of what we're working through right now.
So, Matt, do you mind hanging on through the break?
Yes, absolutely.
All right, cool. So we're going to go ahead and take a quick break, get our advertisers their time, and we'll see. Yeah, in the news, and we'll see you in just a couple minutes.
Stay tuned, WGSO.
Spirits on Bourbon. Spirits on Bourbon. Come to 615 Bourbon, home of the resurrection. Try their gumbo, wings, couchon de lait, or a ribeye steak. Have a shot on Edward's barber chair or sit at his haunted table. Check out their website at spiritsonbourbon.com and watch their video from Spike TV's Bar Rescue. Come to Spirits on Bourbon for a haunting good time.
Wits In Bar and Pizza Kitchen. Wits In is an upscale neighborhood bar and pizza kitchen in the heart of Mid-City at 141 North Carrollton. Wits In is open 7 days a week, and the kitchen is always open late. Make Wits In your home for sports.
With 18 TVs, the NFL package, and the SCC channel, you'll never miss a game. Check out our food and drink specials like Thursday, $5 pizzas, and the Witmaker at WITSINN.com. Witsin Bar and Pizza Kitchen. Think, drink, live, laugh.
Come to New Orleans' friendly local gaming shop, Gopher Games, located on 701 David Drive in Metairie. Games like Warhammer, War Machine, Magic the Gathering, HeroClix, Pathfinder, and many more. Visit us at gophergamesnola.com. That's G-O, the number 4, gamesnola.com for the latest news and upcoming events. We're open 7 days a week. Call us at 504-324-8335 or come on by. Gopher Games, a hangout for gamers by gamers.
Leave the smoke behind and come chase the clouds at the Vaping Tiger in Metairie. The Vaping Tiger has everything to suit your vaping needs, from starter kits to advanced devices. We specialize in handcrafted, artisan-blended e-juices designed to tickle the most fickle taste buds. Come see us at 2812 Athenia Parkway, one block off Vets behind the Lazy Boy Gallery. That's the Vaping Tiger, 2812 Athenia Parkway, and at VapingTiger.com. Come out of the smoke and join us in the clouds.
This is the Blaze Radio News. I'm Kay Long. Trump mania. Huge crowds turning out for the Republican frontrunner. The Blaze Radio's Brad James.
And you know, we're leading in every poll. We're leading in just about every state, including Alabama.
Trump's campaign moving the rally to a 43,000-seat football stadium in Alabama. Mobile's mayor says 30,000 people attending the event. The billionaire taking shots at GOP rivals, former Florida Governor Jeb Bush and Florida Senator Marco Rubio.
Florida, we have a governor and we have a sitting senator, and I'm killing them. Explain that. Obviously, they're not doing a very good job.
The Bush campaign countering the rally by flying a small plane, pulling a banner over the rally that says, Trump for higher taxes, Jeb for Prez. Brad James, The Blaze News.
They head out for a European vacation and come back heroes.
He didn't say a word. He looked like he might have been on drugs or maybe, because he just looked so out of it. He just didn't look like he was, I don't know, all the way there, I guess you can say.
That's Sacramento State College student Anthony Sadler describing a terrorist he and his two buddies take down on a train from Amsterdam to Paris. One of the friends, Alex Scarlatos, an Oregon National Guard member who does a tour in Afghanistan, the other, U.S. Air Force member Spencer Stone, stopping the man when he opens fire with an automatic weapon. Scarlatos calling the terrorist armed to the teeth.
He definitely planned a shooting, though. He had about 7 or 8 magazines in his backpack with him and 2 firearms, so he was there to do business, that's for sure.
The three friends and a man from Great Britain subdue the man and tie him up. The terrorist, a 26-year-old Moroccan who cuts Stone with a box cutter, reports our Stone will be fine. This is news on the Blaze Radio Network. Truth lives here.
In a New Orleans that never was and never will be, airships float high above the city while platoons of clockwork automatons patrol the streets below. In Storyville, pirates, streetwalkers, gamblers, and thieves prowl back alleys in search of their next mark. New Orleans by Gaslight, the premier anthology of locally written and locally produced steampunk poetry and fiction, all set in Victorian New Orleans. Buy it now, available in both paperback and Kindle versions at Amazon.com. New Orleans by Gaslight. Tubby and Coos Mid-City Bookshop. Before you get booked up, head over to 631 North Carrollton right off Orleans to Tubby and Coos Mid-City Bookshop. Off the books, Tubby and Coos is a nerd mecca for books, board games, and geeky t-shirts. So book it over to Tubby and Coos Mid-City Bookshop at 631 North Carrollton. If you don't want to do it by the book, use their free Wi-Fi and check their stock at tubbyandcoos.com. Tubby and Coos Mid-City Bookshop, where it's all geek to me.
Spirits on Bourbon. Spirits on Bourbon. Come to 615 Bourbon, home of the resurrection. Try their gumbo, wings, couchon de lait, or a ribeye steak. Have a shot on Edward's barber chair or sit at his haunted table. Check out their website at spiritsonbourbon.com and watch their video from Spike TV's Bar Rescue. Come to Spirits on Bourbon for a haunting good time.
Wits Inn Bar and Pizza Kitchen. Wits Inn is an upscale neighborhood bar and pizza kitchen in the heart of Mid-City at 141 North Carrollton. Wits Inn is open 7 days a week, and the kitchen is always open late. Make Wits Inn your home for sports. With 18 TVs, the NFL package, and the SEC channel, you'll never miss a game. Check out our food and drink specials like Thursday $5 pizzas and the Wit Maker at WITSINN.com. Wits Inn Bar and Pizza Kitchen. Think, drink, live, laugh.
You got the touch. You got the power. Yeah.
My name is Optimus Prime, and you are listening to The Week in Geek. Autobots, transform and roll out.
Welcome back, New Orleans. You're listening to The Week in Geek on WGSO 990 AM. This is Brian Held with...
Rodimus Prime. All right, so let's bring Matt back on.
And, yeah, Matt with Megabots Incorporated. Where you there, Matt?
Hey, guys. I'm here.
All right, Matt. So, look, you know, we just had Optimus Prime on the show, so I want to talk a little bit of the tail of the tape, the boxing term, about what are the current stats of the Mark II, and after this Kickstarter succeeds, which I know it will, what more improvements? I mean, where are we at now, and where do you hope to bring it? Because, I mean, give me the tonnage, et cetera, you know, and then what you're going to do with it once it succeeds.
Sure. Okay, so right now the Mark II is a 15-foot tall, 12,000-pound robot powered by a pretty weak little engine. It's actually a 24-horsepower gasoline engine. It goes about 3 miles an hour on a set of old, refurbished Caterpillar skid steer treads, so something like a big Bobcat.
Okay.
After the Kickstarter's over, we're hoping to improve that engine by about five times. So it'll be about five times more powerful, meaning the hydraulics can swing punches and move the arms about five times faster. The treads, we're going to put an updated set of treads on it that should get it up to around, we're targeting 15 miles an hour. We think that actually might be too fast, too dangerously fast, depending on how good the balance system is. But this thing's 15 feet up in the air, so if you can imagine being up 15 feet in the air and traveling 15 miles an hour when the thing's turning and spinning around, it gets a little bit wobbly. So we're trying to put on a dynamic balancing system so that the thing can actually respond to taking punches, throwing punches, and it'll catch its balance, and when it gets hit, it kind of staggers back, and so it can stay upright a whole lot safer.
I'm just suddenly filled with images of playing MechCore, right, at all the cons. Are you familiar with MechCore?
I was a big Mech Warrior player back in the day, but I'm assuming it's kind of the same deal.
MechCore is... Yeah, it's based off of Mech Warrior, right? And it's these huge pods, these guys out of Houston take it around to all the local conventions, and yeah, you're playing Battle
Don't Tech. You just need a whole lot of heat dampers?
Yeah.
That's a real...
Yeah, just sit in a body of water, yeah.
Yeah. All right,
of course.
Right.
All right, so once again, you know, how can the listeners help you with the Kickstarter? Well,
hey, real quick, when we started this interview, or actually the start of the show, you were at $307,000. I'm looking now, it's at $309,000.
Yes!
This is great.
The power of America. AM radio.
Yeah.
America!
So,
$2,000 of raw American patriotism that just flowed in.
I'm gonna go home and barbecue me some meat tonight too. Watch some American football.
Yep.
All right, Matt. All right. Well, look, megabots.com is where they can go, and the visit Kickstarter page is a big green button on your website. Anything else you want to tell us before you head out? Because we're excited. We're Americans, and we want to help you.
Hell yeah. Just support Megabots. Let's do this, America. This is our chance to bring all of your childhood dreams to reality. It's time. The technology is here. The team has been assembled. All we need is your support. Let's do this.
Fantastic.
Yes, well said. And the video is great that they have on the website.
It's really Kickstarter.
Well. Yeah, it's great.
Dude, I got a little misty.
I did.
Yeah.
You know? Well, Matt, man, thank you so much for your time today, and we truly appreciate having you on the show, man.
Awesome. Thanks for having me on, guys.
All right.
All right. So let's move on. And you know what we got to do, Brian? It's Book of the Month. It's we got 2 more weeks before the end of the Book of the Month.
Yes.
And I was told that, you know, somebody really enjoys this song. So without much further ado, the Book of the Month.
Oh, geez.
Check this out, y'all.
That's where our boy Evan Roth and his lovely wife.
Oh, yeah.
Thank you for passing on that knowledge that Brian hates us so much, but our listeners love it.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. No, in fact, Evan called me the other day and said that his wife, somebody can't refer to a book to his wife without her immediately thinking of that
read
song.
Read a book. Read a book. All right. So what is our Book of the Month, Brian?
Our Book of the Month is Starship Troopers by Robert Heinlein. It is my absolute most favorite book on this planet. I love it. I buy copies and give it to people just because I think it's awesome.
And you can only buy it at Tubby and Coos.
For a 10% discount.
Oh, from, yeah, okay. You sure?
Yes.
I still don't believe you. All right. You know, also, this comes in from one of our correspondents out there in the world, the real world, not radio world.
Okay.
This song was suggested to me as a Brian Super Groovy hit.
Okay.
So, you know, we haven't done a Brian Super Groovy hit of the week in forever. So why don't we go ahead and do Brian Held Super Groovy hit of the week.
And now, Brian Held Super Groovy hit of the week.
Party on, Wayne. Party on, Garth.
Join DJ Brian Held as he opens his music vault to search for another hit.
I'm picking out a thermos for you.
Wow, what a totally amazing, excellent discovery. Not.
Now sit back and enjoy the musical stylings of DJ Brian Held and his Super Groovy Hit of the Week.
Straight out of Gotham, crazy mother named Two-Face. Check the clock, put the cash in a suitcase. Flip a coin to choose, you know I never lose. Bruce Wayne be wearing concrete shoes. Same thing goes for you, boy wonder. Step to me and be 6 feet under. One coin flip will seal your fate. Shout out to all my homies up in Blackgate. Jim Gordon Kent with me.
So is this because of the recent release of Straight Outta Compton?
Yes.
Okay.
And I think they must have timed it perfectly because there's a video that goes along with it.
Yeah.
And it's pretty fun. Straight Outta Gotham. Crazy mother named Ice Cube. Here's the Joker. This is for you, Tim.
Okay.
I had to edit it up because it was a 5 minute long video.
Okay.
Word up to Arkham.
All right.
So, Straight out of Gotham.
It's a little bit catchy.
It is. Because it's based off of NWA, bruh.
Well, no, look, I can appreciate some NWA, all right? But, you know.
You're so white, Brian.
I am.
Crazy honky named Hell.
Yes.
Jesus. So the video is pretty funny. It's all homemade. I mean, you know, like homemade costumes and stuff like that. But it's pretty cool. No, it's a 5 minute video. City of Gotham is the name of it.
Okay.
And that came from my brother Mo.
Well.
For show from Mo. All right. You know, now we got to do some top nerd news.
Oh, no. Yeah.
I know we got so much crap to do. So without much further ado, top nerd news.
Now, our top nerd news stories from around the world, brought to you by Media Underground Comics. Find them on the World Wide Web at MediaUndergroundComics.com. And now, your top nerd news stories.
All right, so first on the list is this article that came up out of that UK site, like Daily Mail or something like that. It was about e-cigarettes are around 95% less harmful than regular smoking. So... I found that very interesting because there's so much, you know, back and forth on the science about that.
Right.
There's so much about, you know, who's funding these studies and stuff like that. I know from me using an e-cigarette, I feel better.
Dude, your hacking cough where I thought you were going to hawk up a piece of lung has gone away.
Yeah, no more cough. It's great. So I personally feel better. But this kind of segues into our sponsor, Vaping Tiger, over on Athenia. Right.
Yeah, you know, your boy over there, he knows his stuff too, man. I mean, he's the one, I mean, he knows his business, but I'm talking about his business in the vaping world, though.
Oh, because, yeah.
You know, he was the one who kind of told us about how the programs that were done to, you know, prove that vaping was bad was done by the same buttheads who do the smoking stuff that say smoking's good for you. Yeah. It's got vitamin C and stuff.
Right.
You say like the vaping units would catch on fire, but when you vape, you don't leave your friggin' thumb on the button for 2 hours solid.
So what I wanted to mention about them is they have some new drip mods and tips.
Oh yeah,
that have Star Wars characters, or like, you know, Spider-Man or Harley Quinn, Batman logos. In fact, I have my e-cig right here, and it has the Knights of the
The Old Republic on
Knights of the Old Republic.
Look at you.
Yeah. So yeah, so all.
Oh, and it's not just a cheesy sticker. It's actually kind of like.
No, it's engraved.
Engraved. Oh, man, that's friggin' awesome.
Yeah, so.
The Vaping Tiger. What, 2812 Athenia?
Yeah.
Across from the Lakeside Mall.
Right behind Lazy Boy.
There you go. All right, so what else we got in the top nerd news?
All kind of crazy stuff. I put this one in last minute, kind of for you, but maybe I shouldn't tell you about it.
Tell me now.
Is the XM42 is the world's first fully handheld grab-and-go flamethrower on the market.
Well, that is handy, because I was going to barbecue tonight, because America! Who doesn't need a handy-dandy for the soccer mom on the go? Here's a flamethrower.
For only $900, you can get a non-pressurized, instant-use flamethrower. Shoots flames 25 feet.
So what was Kevin Smith's take on Ronda Rousey as Captain Marvel? Because I know my take.
He's all for it.
Really? Kevin Smith, you're stupid.
He is.
Why? Why?
I think he thinks she'd be great.
If the Captain Marvel movie was going to be about, you know, legitimate fighting, yeah, get Ronda Rousey. But I don't know what her acting chops are, and I'm not going to risk a Marvel movie in the hands of a world-class fighter, but not a world-class actor.
She was in Fast and Furious.
Dude, the feminazis would probably go bat-snot crazy if they picked her, because they'd be like, well, she's not who we want to hold up to be. I'm just saying.
Well, I mean, look, she definitely looks the part.
She
right?
does look the part. I mean, I wouldn't. If I saw her coming down a dark alley, I would book it. I would start booking.
Right.
But I mean, you know, she can fight. I mean, I don't think the last two fights, I don't think they've gone more than like 30 seconds.
So, 34 seconds was the last.
I mean,
fight.
She is smoking hot, but I don't know what her what her acting chops are.
She was in Furious 7, The Expendables 3.
She was in that new movie that movie that was on used to be an HBO series that went.
Oh, you know, look, maybe she can get an acting coach and really, you know, do the part justice.
I don't know. I'm not feeling the Kevin Smith vibe as of lately, right. Though.
Okay,
so just saying. All right, well, on the other side of this break, we're going to do some this weekend geek history.
Yeah,
do we have anything else that we need to do?
We might cover a couple more items on the top nerd news.
All right. NolaShops.com. Go see our ugly faces. All right. And thanks to Tubby and Coos, because we did trivia night there last
night.
It was
last
fun.
Night, yeah.
All right. So stay tuned. This is The Weekend Geek. I'm your host, David DeCorbier, with
Brian Held.
And this is WGSO 990 AM.
Come to New Orleans' friendly local gaming shop, Gopher Games, located on 701 David Drive in Metairie. Games like Warhammer, War Machine, Magic the Gathering, HeroClix, Pathfinder, and many more. Visit us at gophergamesnola.com. That's G-O, the number 4, gamesnola.com. For the latest news and upcoming events. We're open 7 days a week. Call us at 504-324-8335 or come on by. Gopher Games, a hangout for gamers by gamers.
Leave the smoke behind and come chase the clouds at the Vaping Tiger in Metairie. The Vaping Tiger has everything to suit your vaping needs, from starter kits to advanced devices. We specialize in handcrafted, artisan-blended e-juices designed to tickle the most fickle taste buds. Come see us at 2812 Athenia Parkway, one block off Vets behind the Lazy Boy Gallery. That's the Vaping Tiger, 2812 Athenia Parkway, and at VapingTiger.com. Come out of the smoke and join us in the clouds.
In a New Orleans that never was and never will be, airships float high above the city while platoons of clockwork automatons patrol the streets below. In Storyville, pirates, streetwalkers, gamblers, and thieves prowl back alleys in search of their next mark. New Orleans by Gaslight, the premier anthology of locally written and locally produced steampunk poetry and fiction, all set in Victorian New Orleans. Buy it now, available in both paperback and Kindle versions at Amazon.com. New Orleans by Gaslight.
Spirits on Bourbon. Spirits on Bourbon. Come to 615 Bourbon, home of the resurrection. Try their gumbo, wings, couchon de lait, or a ribeye steak. Have a shot on Edward's barber chair or sit at his haunted table. Check out their website at spiritsonbourbon.com and watch their video from Spike TV's Bar Rescue. Come to Spirits on Bourbon for a haunting good time.
Wits End Bar and Pizza Kitchen. Wits End is an upscale neighborhood bar and pizza kitchen in the heart of Mid-City at 141 North Carrollton. Wits End is open 7 days a week and the kitchen is always open late. Make Wits End your home for sports. With 18 TVs, the NFL package, and the SCC channel, you'll never miss a game. Check out our food and drink specials like Thursday $5 pizzas and the Wit Maker at WITSINN.com. Wits End Bar and Pizza Kitchen. Think, drink, live, laugh.
Tubby and Coos Mid-City Bookshop. Before you get booked up, head over to 631 North Carrollton right off Orleans to Tubby and Coos Mid-City Bookshop. Off the books, Tubby and Coos is a nerd mecca for books, board games, and geeky t-shirts. So book it over to Tubby and Coos Mid-City Bookshop at 631 North Carrollton. If you don't want to do it by the book, use their free Wi-Fi and check their stock at tubbyandcoos.com. Tubby and Coos Mid-City Bookshop, where it's all geek to me.
This is Zorak, and you're listening to The Week in Geek on 990 AM.
Welcome back, New Orleans. This is The Week in Geek on WGSO 990 AM. This is Brian Held with
Captain Picard. Well, what's his name? Is that Paul Blunt? Not Paul Blart. Blunt Talk. That's Picard's new TV show
with
on,
Sir Patrick Star. Stewart.
Blunt Talk, Sir Patrick. Yeah. Sir Patrick. It doesn't say Sir on there.
It doesn't, but he is knighted.
Oh, it is tonight, 9 p.m. on Star.
I've heard nothing but good stuff about that.
Yeah, yeah. It looks like he's really buku out of his comfort zone, and he said he's really happy about it.
Something about, you know, if he goes in every day and just laughs for like 12, 14 hours straight.
Well, you know, apparently, like, when he first got on Star Trek, he had a serious stick up his butt, and like they were like, dude, you know, you're supposed to have a little fun with this role as the captain of the Enterprise. He's like, no, I'm serious. I'm a Shakespearean actor. So he's really gone.
Oh, real quick, our fan out in Finland, Charlotte.
Oh, she's right? Awake?
Yeah, I guess so. But she just sent us a message. Helsinki won the bid for Worldcon in 2017.
So, oh, nice.
You know, go Charlotte and whole team out there that were pushing for that bid. You
congratulations.
Know. Yeah, very happy for them.
All right.
All right, 12 days.
12 days.
12 days.
Or a partridge in a pear tree. No.
To Dragon Con.
Oh, that's a big partridge.
I know. And lots of folks are freaking out about it. You know, so we're going to miss it this year.
Yeah.
But
Before we do This Week in Geek History, Fear the Walking Dead starts tomorrow night, the new Walking Dead spinoff. Actually kind of excited about it. I think it's actually going to be pretty good. And I'm going to be doing some Fear the Walking Dead recap in 60 seconds.
There you go.
So,
which is end up 2.5 minutes.
Yeah, something like that. Hey, it's just the title. It's right. Just the title. All right, so Daryl, let's do a little bit of This Week in Geek History.
This Week in Geek History.
We're sending you back to the future.
Yes!
This Week in Geek History is brought to you by Tubby and Coos Mid-City Bookshop. Check them out at tubbyandcoos.com. Tubby and Coos Mid-City Bookshop, the nerd mecca. This Week in Geek History.
All right, so we're going to get right into it. First item on my list, August 17th, 1979. Monty Python's Life of Brian, as directed by Terry Jones, was released.
Always look on the bright side of life.
What's next? All right.
That's going to be stuck in everybody's head now. I know. You're welcome.
Yes. August 17, 1970. Venera 7 is launched toward Venus.
Venera what?
Venera V.
We sent the VD to VE.
Venera V E N E R A. Venera.
Oh, okay.
7 is launched toward Venus. It's the first craft that broadcasts a signal from the surface of another planet.
Ooh, well done.
Yeah, that's awesome. All right. Let's see. You'll like this. Okay. Next one, August 18th, 1877. Yeah, it's a real old one. Asaf Hall discovers the Martian moon Phobos from the U.S. Naval Observatory.
Phobos.
Which then, I thought you'd appreciate, reminded me of the Leather Goddesses of Phobos, that old Infocom game. The text-based adventure.
Yes.
You're welcome, Dave.
Well, thank you.
See, I'll look out for you.
Yeah, appreciate it.
All right. Next is August 20th, 1982. Starring Mark Singer, Tanya Roberts, John Amos, and Rip Torn, the Beastmaster.
Beastmaster! God, that's the little ferrets and then those creepy things with like the gimp masks on, you know?
Kodo and Podo were the ferrets, yes.
Yeah.
Okay. I watched that so much.
God, I haven't seen that movie in years.
The tagline, born with courage of an eagle, the strength of a black tiger, and the power of a god.
Dude, we need to have like a watch party for that. That's one of the, when the weather turns and gets cool again, we're going to have to do another movie viewing at Tubby and Coos.
That would be cool.
I vote on that movie.
All right. No, I met Mark Singer at Dragon Con. He was so cool.
Man. Yeah, he's in the new Flash series too.
That's awesome.
Yeah, he was one of the generals, I think.
All right, this one's a little strange. August 22nd, 2001. The Trojan Room coffee pot, the inspiration for the webcam, was switched off at 9:54 UTC.
Was that English you just spoke? What the hell did you just tell me?
So the Trojan
Room. Your mom, Brian.
The Trojan Room is this server room that's I believe it's Cambridge. And they said,
what the hell are you talking about?
Let me finish.
I'm not a smart man.
They had a camera set up, all right,
okay,
watching the pot, so that folks on the internet could see it. Basically, the people in the building could see the pot and see when it's full or empty to know to go over there.
So like Schrodinger's cat? Is the coffee? Was it a pot of coffee?
It's just a pot of coffee, yeah.
So people wanted to make sure they still had coffee.
Right. So they wouldn't waste a trip walking over there. Right?
Wow.
Yes.
Now that's the epitome of laziness.
But I just think it's so. But it is
Schrodinger's coffee?
But that thing inspired webcams.
Okay.
Yeah. So there you go. The Trojan Room coffee pot.
All right. Good. Daryl stopped playing the computer. He kept looking at pictures of Ronda Rousey. He was messing with me, man. I'm just like, because she's like really hot. She would make a very aesthetically pleasing Captain Marvel. All
right. You want some birthdays?
Yes.
All right. August 17th, Donnie Wahlberg.
Donnie Wahlberg.
Yeah.
Wahlbergers. That's a top show.
August 19th, Diana Mulder. She played Dr. Pulaski on Star Trek, Next Generation.
Oh.
Yep.
She was boring.
Jonathan Frakes from Captain Riker.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. I'm sorry. Well, Commander Riker.
Commander Riker.
Yeah. Oh, he was Captain at one point. August 20th, James Marsters. Spike on Buffy.
Oh, yeah.
Yep. Also on the 20th, Jonathan Ki Kwan. Short round.
It's Frakes. Oh, no time for love, Dr. Jones.
Yes. And on August
23rd. Hang on, lady. We go for ride. We got 20 seconds left.
Carrie Ann Moss from Trinity.
Okay. Research. All right, hang on, Mr. Held. We go for a ride. This end of show. All right, guys. Till next time. Jesus, you know the deal. Like Facebook, share it for us. Till next time. Keep your nerd flag raised high.
GFL.
Share. Leave the smoke.